My father, he thinks I'm insane.
From the writers of Lost and the creators of Once Upon a Time.
You claimed you traveled to this place, Wonderland.
You fell in love with the genie.
I'm gonna find him.
She's not the Alice you thought you knew.
I sense that you can take care of yourself.
Thursday, the search for her lost love begins.
All right, Rabbit, dig your hole.
Once Upon a Time in Wonderland, series premiere Thursday at 8, 7 central, followed by an all-new Grey's Anatomy and Scandal on ABC.
You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment. The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California. Presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com. And streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's Nashville After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Nashville After Show.
Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining us again for another AfterBuzz TV show for Nashville. It's episode 3 called I Don't Want to Talk About It Now. Mm. It's probably Rayna who never wants to talk about
anything. Or Deacon.
Yeah,
or Deacon,
that's true. I'm your host, JJ Jurgens, and I'm joined here tonight by...
Hi, you guys. My name is Keetin Marchi.
Hi, you guys. Whitney Lane.
Hey, hey. Violet Kanian.
And we have a very special treat for you. A tweet I about sent. For you Nashville fans tonight, we have a special guest in studio.
Woo, I'm Chaley Rose.
Yay. Woo! Zoey!
Zoey in the house!
Thank you so much for coming and joining us tonight. We're
Thank
so excited
you for having
to
have you. Me. It's hilarious.
We're excited for the inside
we're
scoop.
Super. Yeah. We are. Yeah, so she's going to give us some good spoilers.
Well, we hope. We're not going to break any contracts here tonight.
Right.
It's the goal.
I'd like to have my job.
Yes, and we want you to have it too.
We won't. I just had to try. Yeah. So we're just going to give you some scoop and ask you some questions. And we're also going to talk about tonight Juliette and Avery. We're going to hit a little bit on Deacon and what he's going through. Rayna now hooking back up with Liam. Oh, dun, dun, dun. And then the whole Scarlet Gunner Zoey will.
Square. It's a love
it
square right now.
Very confusing. Yeah, another great episode. We'll get into it.
Before we get into that, let me just give a little shout out for Once Upon a Time in Wonderland. I don't know if you guys have heard about this show, but it's starting this Thursday, October 10th. It's going to be on at 8, 7 central on ABC. It's made by the creators of Lost. If you know about Once Upon a Time, it's kind of a spin-off of that, so it's supposed to be really awesome and a completely new spin on the Alice in Wonderland story. So to make sure to tune in, 8, 7 central.
Tomorrow.
Yeah.
Mm. Ooh.
October 10th.
Cool.
Sounds good.
Just jump into this episode, guys.
All right.
It's awesome. It's national time.
Woo. All right. Well, let's start off with Juliette and Avery.
Oh, boy.
What they're going through.
I think they're so cute together.
They are.
I really like them together.
They really are. And it's like you think finally Juliette has like this friend that she can count on and she knows that he's a friend, but no, she doesn't.
He's really just on the payroll, people.
He is, right?
Yeah. We know this.
How crushing when she delivered that blow to him. You know?
I mean, isn't it expected?
Yes.
I don't think it's like weird. I feel like she always says something like that and she's probably done it before to him. Like, that's it's about true. Time you walk away.
She was being entirely too nice the episode anyway, because she really hadn't done anything like that. So she had to do something. What do you feel about Juliette and how she treats people?
I think it's just, you know, a little bit of self-defense. Mm-hmm. I don't think she means it.
Yes.
I don't think she means to be mean.
Yeah.
Although sometimes I think she enjoys it.
That's a good one.
But I think in this situation, I don't think she meant it.
Mm. And if you ever played, like, the bad girl... Do you have fun?
No, I would love to play a huge bitch. I think it would be so much fun.
Yeah?
But like the kind of mean girl who enjoys being mean. Mm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like straight up mean girls.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Regina George over there.
I get so hard, yeah?
I mean,
yeah.
I don't see it from
like,
I'm really nice,
yeah.
Mostly.
See that little sideways glance over there?
We have, if you cannot see, her boyfriend EJ is right next to her.
Well, if you think about, like, last season, we hated Avery. Mm-hmm. Avery was, like, the spawn of Satan. Like, every episode, we're like, he's disgusting. He's annoying. I hate him. He's stupid. Why would he be mean to Scarlett like that? Da, da, da. And, like, now this whole season, we're like, Avery's so sweet. Look how cute they are. He's so nice.
He still gets on my nerves, though. He always
has. A little bit, yeah.
I can't help it.
Well, and I think he almost, like, he kind of deserves being treated like this a little bit, because that's kind of what he did, you know.
I think that's why I kind of liked the two of them together, is because he ends up being softer with her, because she is so bad. But I like that he puts her in her place, and he says things back to her that most people won't. So I think that's why I kind of rooted for this one a little bit.
She's so used to people being like a yes man to her and going with whatever she says, and he's finally the one person who's like, no, like, you're stupid. What are you doing? Mm-hmm.
He says it how it is, and she does not like to hear that, that's for sure. So she needs him in her life, but he just walked out. So we'll see what happens with them.
He's never coming back.
Well, it was an interesting little performance she put on for $1 million. Mm. Like, does that happen?
The show
lot,
or the performance
for afterwards?
Yeah, for the Wentworth. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm like, she had a couple shows.
I was talking about her after show for $1 million.
The after party.
Don't you remember on Super Sweet 16, whenever the kids would like get like, oh, I'm having like Bow Wow perform at my birthday party and it costs $500,000. So I feel craziness. Like Juliette is like the level of Taylor Swift at this point. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I feel like she probably brings a pretty big, heavy penny or whatever.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that was totally believable for me to watch that. Yeah.
At least it got her out of performing for Ed Schill, because she sure does not like that man. Mm-mm. But no one really does.
Right.
He needs to... Somebody's going to put him in this place. We'll see. See it happen.
Raina's trying to, but...
Yeah, it's going
to
be Raina.
Well, not if she can't sing anymore, people. He's going to have a hard time. We'll see.
That's about to get
awkward. Yeah, but speaking of the after party... called that one early on.
You did.
Yes,
you did.
I caught a lot of things tonight. I, like, literally wrote them down. I would show them to Keetin during the show. I was like, look, I wrote that.
Before it happened.
I bet this is going to happen. And then it did. But, like, you just assume she's going to hook up with somebody on every episode, and it had to be the husband.
Right.
Well, because it's always going to be usually the person that's the worst choice possible or worst situation
morally wrong, and she does it every time.
New hot guy, Julia's going to hit it.
I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. We'll see. I feel like his wife's gonna, something's gonna come out of that.
I think he's gonna, like, hit it and quit it. He's gonna be done.
Oh, well, yeah. He's married.
Yeah, I think she's... But I actually thought it was going to maybe happen earlier, and then I thought Avery was going to find out and get mad, and I thought that guitar that he loved so much was going to get bashed.
That would have been a great one.
No, Avery would never destroy a guitar that's, like, that amazing. Like, he would steal it before he smashed it.
Good point.
I read the episode, and when I was reading it, I was like, she's not going to do it.
Yeah.
She made it to the very end.
I know.
It was so close.
Surprising, too, because I thought maybe during the performance something was going to, like... right in front of the wife, at least like eyes or something, you know, but she like walked away and then it happened.
In Juliette's defense though, she tried to say no. She tried.
She kind of tried.
Kind of. I don't give her too many props for
courtesy,
that one.
Courtesy decline.
She's like, wait, but you're married. Okay.
My type, as we talked about last week. Real life comes into play. So we dropped a big gossip bomb last week that we read that Hayden herself actually was caught kissing Jay Hernandez, who is married. So we're like, the storyline has come true. Life, who knows if it was true?
Art.
Some gossip there, but she really did.
We don't know if it's true though.
No, but Juliette hooked up with the married man, so not the way to go. Oh well.
Not a good choice.
No.
All right, well, I think we've exhausted them. We're done with Julia for right now.
Well, let's talk about one of our favorite topics here. Let's get back into some Deacon.
He's awesome.
I wish we just had, like, we should have a Deacon sound effect. Like, just anytime we talk about Deacon, we should have
sexy.
Women something like bound chicka, wah, wah.
yummy.
No, but we were all talking the whole night about how amazing he was in this episode. Oh, so fantastic. Much emotion. It was very believable for sure. I mean, he always impresses me, but, man, he's going through a lot. So many ups and downs and, like, you know, nightmares in the middle of the night. The Scarlet comes in on it, and then Coleman, he just, like, lashes out, mm-hmm. but then realizes I better thank him for all that he's done.
And nice to see Coleman again.
Mm-hmm. I know. It's sad that he's moving away. Mm-hmm. So you told us that a while back, that he was going to be off the show or a recurring character. So no more Coleman for us.
No more Coleman. Mm-hmm. I like him.
Did you when you were there, do you get to see any of Deacon's scenes? Is there shooting or?
I've never actually gotten to watch him, which I would love to do because he's amazing. I encounter him from time to time. He gives the best hugs.
Oh, no. Jealous. Very.
I love it. Just what we want to know about Deacon.
Yeah, tell us more.
No, I've never gotten to watch him, though. He's amazing. Mm-hmm.
What's it like interacting with the cast, though? Is it a close-knit cast? I mean, it's only season two, so. Right.
No, they really are. But the best thing is that they kind of welcomed me with open arms.
That's what I was going to say.
You know, especially, like, Claire. She reached out to me before we even started shooting, which is awesome and I think kind of rare between chicks on a set.
Yeah.
You know? Even Hayden.
Like, so you were still here when she reached out to you?
Yeah, she got my number and just like, because we're playing best friends, and she was like, we should meet up, get some coffee or something. Yeah.
Become real life friends so that it translates. That's smart.
Yeah.
That's good to know.
Good, yeah. And I think it shows on screen too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah. Excellent job.
it's nice to know they're like good people.
Yeah. You
know? They really are. Yeah. I mean, and I'm not BSing you. Can I swear?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm really not, you. Though. Okay, I'm not bullshitting you. Everyone's really cool. I've never, like, I have so much fun when I'm there. Everyone's, for whatever reason, everyone seems to be especially funny. Or maybe it's just me. I just laugh the whole time.
That's fun.
Are you ever in a scene where you just can't, like, you guys just keep, like, cracking up, and it comes to the point where you have to just, like, stop down for, like, 5 minutes?
That has happened to me twice. And it's me, though. I have a really weird sense of humor, so it'll be a moment where it doesn't call for laughter. Or there was one scene where I completely, like, I told the camera operator, I was like, I might look down the barrel. Because, you know, they're kind of rotating around the room. And it's always weird when you look into the camera.
Have, like, a gym moment from The Office.
Yeah. But, you know, so I was like, damn it, Tommy, I did it. And the scene wasn't over.
Oh.
I stepped on Jonathan's line, and then I was like, oh, shit. And then I was afraid everyone's going to be mad, but they laughed.
Oh, good.
Yeah. But I have that problem of, like, laughing when I shouldn't be. I'm so sorry.
That's great. I love it. It makes it entertaining, at least.
Yeah.
Might as well have some fun if you're spending so many hours
a
day.
True. Yeah. It is a lot of fun, though.
Yeah.
Do you know who I don't think laughed this entire episode was? Deacon. Like, I feel like every single scene he was in, it was just, like, super downer. Like, oh, my gosh, like, you're yelling at Coleman. That was intense. Mm-hmm. Like, he's in the middle of an AA meeting, and he just, like, did he throw a chair? Did he pull, he pulled like an Indiana basketball coach movie through a chair. Like, come on, man.
Yeah, I mean.
Bobby Knight.
Pull the Bobby Knight.
He just has so much going through his mind right now, I feel like.
But I liked it. It was another good nugget, you know, because it's like Coleman dropped the bomb, you know, about his dad, and then immediately we get to see him give the wonderful performance and telling us what he went through with his dad. I thought it was great to see another little level.
Layer,
of,
like the layers peeling back and finding out why Deacon is the way he is, why he became an alcoholic in the first place. I mean, it stemmed from his dad abusing his family. I mean, that cannot be easy to grow up in. And now he's like, I mean, I'm sure it's weighing on him because now he has a child. So he's like, I can't be like my dad, even though he said I was going to be. I think it's all of that going through his mind.
Well,
right
and you saw him go in and try to, like, basically go to Teddy and be like, you know what, you're her dad. Like, he kind of was like, I want hands off the situation. And Teddy turned it right back on him and was like, no, dude, doesn't matter. Like, she knows now that you're her father. You need to step up. Mm-hmm. Like, it was nice that he came in and apologized. Mm-hmm. And I kind of, like, was pissed Teddy was so hard on him, but I think he needed kind of that slap in the face of get your shit together, sorry. And because he wasn't listening, like, Rayna doesn't want to talk about it.
Right.
She won't talk about it. So I'm glad Teddy stepped up and was like, no, you need to take responsibility for Maddie.
And I think Teddy is kind of talking about himself too while he's talking to Deacon. So I like that connection they had there.
I also think it's because now Deacon was looking for a chance to run away. Mm-hmm. And it's very convenient for him to just be able to say, no, no, you've been a dad this whole time. You just continue to be the dad. And I'm going to step away so that I don't end up hurting the child like my dad did. So he was clearly trying to run away. And it was nice that Teddy didn't let that happen. And
I know, but I'm interested to see how he actually does interact with Maddie, because it's inevitable. It's going to happen. I mean, we see in the preview for next week that she runs away. Like, she's dealing with a lot, too, so he's going to have to... It's going to be interesting how he kind of treads with that relationship.
And I love that he's finally evolving, and he's not... Hopefully, he's not going to be all depressed in coming episodes.
Yeah, I think he hit his bottom, and I think he's kind of on his way up now.
Like, let's hope.
Yes. He had a turning point in this episode. She's like, you know.
She does know. We're like looking at you every time I say something.
I'm trying to see what her reaction is on her face. Like,
Deacon comes out.
Oh.
Sorry.
Wait, Deacon comes.
Deacon
wait,
and a Will. What? We didn't see that one coming.
She's like, what?
What?
I would die.
That would be like, I would not see that one coming. I would be like, okay, writers, touche. Touche.
I love it. Yeah, so we'll see. Good stuff from Deacon this episode.
Yes, yes, there was. Well, if you were looking for other good stuff to watch, we have a great movie for you guys to check out, Serial Buddies. You can get it at Amazon, Target, Barnes & Noble. Barnes & Noble. I don't know what happens when it's 12 o'clock at night. I can't talk. Barnes & Noble, all kinds of places. And it was produced by Kevin Undergaro and Maria Menounos, who lead us all here. So we'd really love it if you could help them out and go and purchase it, tell a friend about it, check it out. It's really funny. It's like a Dexter meets Dumb and Dumb. Very entertaining movie, so if you need a little laughs, check it out. All right, now let's move on to talk a little bit about Rayna and her hooking back up with Liam.
Oh, girls Rayna. Getting cray in her single life.
Girls acting like Juliet. I'm sorry. Yeah. Girls acting like Juliet.
At least it's the same guy, kind of, sort of.
Yeah. Well, she's always between three.
Yeah,
so.
But at the beginning of the episode, he completely rejected her. Like, kind of threw it back in her face and was very rude to her. And then, like, 10 minutes later, it seemed like, hey, yeah, just kidding.
Yeah, that was weird.
I think he just wanted her to feel that, whatever he felt, so.
She never really does, though, because she always ends up getting her way.
That's true.
You know? It's not like he walked out of her life. Like, they're still going to produce an album.
Or left her at the airport.
Maybe.
Yeah, she does always get her way. Like,
eventually. Yeah. I mean, it took, like, what, 20 minutes before you came back?
Right?
She's like, so are we going to finish this album?
Yeah.
Sure.
A.K.A. are we going to hook up again?
Sleep with me, and I will produce that album. Not really, but you see the chemistry? I don't know. I don't mind it right now, because I feel like Deacon's dealing with this stuff. Soon enough, you know, I'm going to want them back together.
Oh, for sure. Oh, man.
Yeah, so we'll see.
Yeah, I guess I think it was too soon. I'm like, come on, you just got out of the, I mean, you
she
were just with Deacon.
She literally just, the day before.
Yeah, you just signed the divorce papers and you just got healthy from an accident. I just was like, come on.
Everything like, moves very quickly, yes.
Yeah.
Pump the brakes, Rayna. Like, and we didn't even see the girls this episode.
Right. Yeah.
We didn't see. No.
Yeah, she's not really thinking about them. That's
out of sight, out of mind.
Yeah,
what is it? Her sister's probably taking care of them. Oh, who cares?
I love the girls, but I didn't quite mind that because, you know, Maddie's being a little kind of bitchy.
So it was,
But still, I mean, going to inevitably come out. I mean, this is a huge country singer. So she's going to eventually, someone's going to find out she's sleeping with Liam, and her daughter's going to find out. It's like, so my dad, my real dad, and now this other dude in my life. That's going to be annoying for her. And that's hard to kind of comprehend, I think.
Yeah.
Rayna,
no,
that's a good, she's good a little point. Bit selfish, which we've talked about.
Yes. Just a little.
And it's, I felt the whole, like, when she admits to him that she doesn't have a voice, like, why him? I don't know. It just felt weird, like, that whole... Like, why would you talk to him about it first? I don't know. Like, you obviously don't trust him. Like, he's not a trustworthy person. He kind of threw that stuff in your face that you were like, you know what? I'm not going to go to St. Lucia. Is that where?
Yeah.
Did I pronounce Lucia?
Lucia.
Lucia?
No, just like St. Lucia.
St. Lucia. St. Lucia.
whatever. He kind of, like, threw that back in her face, and then she's like, okay, it's okay. And now I'm going to tell you, like, my deepest, darkest secret right now. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if he blackmailed her.
Oh. Ooh.
Not yet. Maybe, but I don't see it really yet. They're happy.
Double cross.
She knows.
I'm so distracted because I just made my boyfriend go get me a tissue.
I know. See, you gotta keep drinking that cardamom tea, you know?
I'm a mouth breather right now.
We appreciate it. You're a trooper. Not feeling well and still here late with us talking tonight.
Fighting my illness.
We're all gonna be sick. Like, only one of us will be here next week.
Oh, man. Thanks. No, but so let's talk a little bit about the party, because that was a huge shocker for the CEO dude. I don't even remember his name.
Jeff.
Oh, yeah. Okay, Fordham. Jeff.
Yes. Mm. That sounds like CEO's name, Jeff
but
Fordham.
I loved her little twist.
Switcheroo.
That she threw up in there, because she can't sing, obviously, but he's a little bit on to why she's not doing it. But still, I like it, because it highlighted Scarlett.
Who, and, by the way, looked freaking gorgeous.
I totally
both those ladies looked
smoking.
Gorgeous.
With their dates that night.
Hey.
Well, Scarlett and Gunnar weren't really dates, but still, I want her dress.
And we all had a big laugh at Gunnar's bite, you know, comment.
What was he's like, oh, I didn't know you could look this good. Is that supposed to be a comment? It was. Like, no. Who in their right mind says that? Thinks that's good for a girl to hear.
No, but I think he was acknowledging, like, when he said, he was acknowledging, I shouldn't have said that out loud.
Right.
Let's move on.
She looked great. Yeah, she had those red lips. That hair was looking good.
And another good, we talked about last week, her having a good, like, comedic moments now, you know? She's definitely the new Scarlett, has a little spunk to her, you know?
And we can understand her.
Yes.
That's what I love. I love that I can understand everything that comes out of her mouth this season so far. It's like she's talking, like, slower and, like, with more confidence. It's great.
Mm-hmm. They're definitely highlighting her awkwardness and making it a point now to make it funny.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I like how we're seeing more of their, like, past lives, because now we've got Scarlett's best friend, Zoey. Mm-hmm. You know, like, we're seeing more people come into it, and I really like that, because you see kind of how they are with different people.
And how they became who they are.
Exactly.
Like, you start understanding them more.
Yeah. How is it working with Claire?
Claire's really sweet. Mm-hmm. I asked Claire, like, when you got, you know, the breakdown for your character was, like, it's fairy. She's like a fairy. Yeah. She's very sweet. She saves animals.
Aww.
She literally, like, has, I think, a mockingbird and
it's
like 7-foot-tall dog on its hind legs.
Uh-huh. You know? Oh, so I'm like, whoa!
That's a Great Dane?
Big old dog.
It's an Australian something. I don't know what it is. But she's really sweet.
That's fun.
Yeah, she's a lot like her character, I would say.
Yeah, that's good to hear. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That works. But
she's from Australia though, right?
Yeah. She is.
Is it interesting, like, being on set with her? When she's on set, does she just, like, talk in her American accent the whole time?
Yeah, she mostly stays Southern.
Mm-hmm.
Most people do.
Yeah.
On set, stay in that Southern accent.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which has to be interesting from people from all over coming to Nashville. What did you think of Nashville?
The city?
Yeah. What do you think? Because y'all shoot there, so what do you think?
I'm from Southern Indiana, so... You know, it was like, as soon as I'm 18, I'm out.
Right.
And when I landed in Nashville and I'm driving from the airport to the hotel, I was like, God.
You're back.
How long am I going to be here?
Welcome back.
So much open space. But it's a great city. I love it.
Do you see a lot of just, you know, regular people walking down the street while y'all are shooting? Because it's kind of in a lot of historic places there.
Yeah, I mean, I do a lot of shooting on stages.
Mm-hmm.
And then every now and then, like, the scene with Scarlett and I just crossing the street, there's extras in the background. So
did they close down streets and stuff for you guys?
Well, no, they'll just kind of stop traffic while we're shooting, and then they let it go again. But I haven't shot a lot in just... open spaces where there's so like the Wild Horse Saloon, the stockholders event, that was like 300 volunteer extras.
Wow.
Yeah. Which is cool.
What about when you shoot at the Bluebird? Because I know that's like one of the main places you're at. Is that a set? Or
it is, and it is like duplicated to a T.
Really?
So interesting.
Yeah, I mean, like, the details are fascinating. Like, the light sockets have, like, they're, like, dingy. Someone did that.
Yeah.
You know, it's cool.
Do you go out much and go and listen to country music while you're there?
I do.
Are people amazing? Everywhere you go.
Yeah. I went to Live on the Green, discovered Moon Taxi. Mm. Ever heard of them?
Interesting.
I guess you would call it Americana.
Okay.
Rock. Like, really. So, like, I'll send EJ albums to download. Like, this is what I'm listening to. So I'm like, it's like a bookmark in my life. Like, this music will always remind me of this experience.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And it's nice, too, that it's not all country. Because you can walk around and it could be, like you said, rock or Americana. Like, that's always cool. You get, like, good mixtures of artists.
Yeah. It's cool. It's a great city.
What are the shooting days like?
I probably shoot, depending on the number of scenes I have in an episode, 2 or 3 days. I don't think anyone really shoots more than 3 days out of 5 business days in a week. Yeah. My first day on set was, they shot me out, and I was there for, I think, 15 hours.
Oh, man.
And it was all in the Bluebird. And it was my first episode. It was pretty. I mean, I was like, I had a really early call time. I left really late. I was so excited. I didn't even realize I was tired.
That's cool. You're enjoying it so much. Yeah. That's how it should be.
Yeah.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah. All right, we'll get into more questions.
Yeah.
We'll wrap up the episode, then we'll talk with you some more.
We have a ton of questions we want to ask.
What else? Well, let's talk a little bit about Will deciding to go ahead and use Gunner's song.
Can I just read you what I wrote?
Yes, you can.
And this is what I showed.
I've seen it.
Will's going to steal some of Gunner's songs, I bet.
First 5 minutes of, like, the episode, she wrote that. And then, like, as soon as it happened, she's like, keep.
And, okay, you can't do that. No. I don't care if you're like, let me give you credit. It's still his song. Like, that could be his future number one. Now, just because you're in front of all these stockholders and whoever else that's big time in Music City, he's going to blow up with that song. It makes me so angry.
Yeah, and especially since he already, like, they had a conversation about it, and he wasn't cool with it. So it's like, you can't just go do that. I'd be furious.
He does what he wants. Really?
Yeah, I think this is going to really help Gunner. I mean, even if you look at the industry in real life, like, okay, for example, country music, Jason Aldean took Brantley Gilbert's song. What was it called?
Yeah, but he buys that song. You know what
I
mean?
They write it. But because of that, like, Brantley Gilbert's name went up. So it's kind of like he's going to be known, more people are going to be interested in him, and more people will start buying his music. I totally get that he stole it. You know, Gunner didn't want it out there. But I think it's going to be good for Gunner at the end.
Yeah. I don't know. I think it's going to be good for him maybe, like, at the beginning, but then I feel like he's going to be pushed so far to the background that he's never going to have a chance to really, you know, shine.
I think he needs to just be with Scarlett. Obviously, they're better together. Yeah. We like them as a duo singing. But
her song was great today.
It was.
I liked it.
I like her alone as well, but I like them together.
Yeah, I do too.
And I don't know.
I like Zoey and Gunner together, personally.
I cannot.
No, please.
Will's after Zoey right now. Mm-hmm. We all know that's
Will doesn't
probably
know
not
what he wants.
Will's confused.
He is confused.
I do like the relationship between Will and his ex-boyfriend, though. Like, that is completely, like, what happened? They're
like cool now.
Mm-hmm. He's very good at acting in public. Man,
I'm telling you, that guy's gonna bite him in the butt. He's gonna blackmail him, and he's gonna get in trouble.
Ooh,
that's gonna happen.
Oh. Yeah, I still look at her.
I wanted to come out.
I agree with you on that one. I still think Jeff is going to use that, like we said, the other 2 episodes ago now, I think. Was that last week?
Yeah, I think definitely something's going to be found out. I mean, Will can't stay in the closet forever when people know, and his ex-boyfriend's, like, working for the company he just got signed to.
He shouldn't have to, really.
He shouldn't have to what?
Stay in the closet. Poor guy.
No, he shouldn't. No.
But, man, don't be leading Zoey on.
Right?
Yeah.
Don't let her think that you're going on a date.
But he could be bi. He could, like, you
he
know.
He could be bi. Eh,
you know.
I don't know.
He should still tell me.
Yeah, right?
Give you a heads up.
Yeah.
So what do you think? Were you excited to go on a date with him?
Or be his date.
Zoey?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that she's, you know, she likes to have fun. She likes the fellas. Yeah.
You do. Zoey's a flirt.
She is a flirt.
She flirts with everybody.
She does.
She uses those eyes. I'll tell you that. You can see it in her eyes.
She gives the eye. She's just, you know, she's just having fun.
That's what we really, we called you out on last week at the end when you were listening to Gunnar sing. We were like, oh.
Look at her
eyes.
Look at her
eyes. Like, those are doomy eyes.
She better not do that to her
I got so much crap because I'm like, you go, Zoey. If it happens, you go. And everyone's like, no, you're horrible. You're horrible. And I'm like, I'm just saying.
Oh, no.
Gunnar's good looking. Talented guy.
Yeah, but we can't get on
Scarlett,
this again.
Scarlett's being rude to him.
No, she's
we can
not.
We can give her perspective.
Like, yeah.
Why should this? It's because we said, no, girl code, you can't go dating Gunnar because that was Scarlett's ex, and girls, just that's a rule.
It is a rule.
What do you think Zoey feels about that rule? Without giving
too much away.
I think that Zoey loves her friend, and she wants her to be happy.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
I think I like where this is going.
But I think if Zoey asked Scarlett, like, hey, you know, me and Gunnar are feeling each other, Scarlett is not the type of person to be like,
no,
you can't do that. Scarlett's like gonna be like, I just want you to be happy. Like, that's exactly
what I do feel like right. Scarlett would say something like
but
that.
But she'd still be hurt.
Yeah, deep down she's like, I'm gonna like Gunnar.
Yeah.
He asked me to marry him.
No, you know what? You snooze, you lose, Scarlett. Get on it, Zoey.
Well, she didn't exactly I mean, there was a lot of things going on.
Right.
With Gunnar.
Poor Gunnar's so sad now. Like, this is the thing. If Zoey would make Gunnar happy right now, like, come on. Don't you just want Gunnar to be happy?
Not really.
I think that's masking his true feelings for Scarlett. Like, go for the best friend when really I still care a lot about Scarlett.
If Zoey was not the best friend, if Zoey had just met Scarlett working then I'm all
different
for
story.
It.
Yeah.
But Zoey's in Nashville for Scarlett. She's there for like support.
Is that why?
Well, is that why?
I'm in Nashville, so we're from Natchez, Mississippi, and I'm a preacher's daughter, and it was just kind of like, if I don't get out now, I'm not going to, and so. I think that it's something Scarlett and Zoey always talked about. You know, let's move to Nashville. Mm-hmm. And she moved the year before me. And so I was like, you know what? I'm going to go. I'm going to go, too.
Is Zoey a singer?
Zoey is a singer.
Oh, interesting. I feel like something was going to
come up. I feel like a preacher's daughter. I'm sure you've been raised in church.
Well, that's why she's trying to flirt, honey. You got to get out of Mississippi. Get to Nashville where the men are.
Well, and hey, even more reason to get with Gunnar. You guys can start writing songs or singing his songs.
That wouldn't be bad.
This is all bad.
I'm playing devil's advocate right now.
So basically, you guys are not
Team Gunner Zoey.
Giving me permission to date anyone. Not Will. Well,
you can have Will.
Yeah, but we could have Will.
I don't want Zoey with Will, though, because she deserves more of a relationship than Will's able to give her.
For Zoey, I wouldn't want her to be with Will.
So right. I don't know, actually.
How about Avery?
How about Deacon?
No.
How about Deacon?
Why not?
Because his niece's best friend.
My boyfriend is like, yeah, Deacon.
Like, hey. Deacon. Wait, not Gunnar with the sexy eyes?
They look pretty together. They look so pretty together.
Or the kind eyes, I'm sorry.
Kind eyes.
You'd have the kind eyes with the sexy eyes.
What do you want for Zoey?
Yeah.
What are your goals for her?
I want Zoey to have the fun that she came to have.
Okay.
You know?
So Zoey's not really looking to settle down.
She wants some Will in her life.
She's good with Will.
I think she's just kind of been, she's a little, she's finding herself. Mm. She's a little lost, maybe.
That makes sense.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay. But Zoey left with Gunnar at the end, right?
Mm-hmm.
That was innocent.
Mm. Okay.
We both, you know.
Just friends, like, our people.
Let's get out of here.
They went to do business.
We're being ignored. Let's leave.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
You know. We shall see.
I feel like there's some good stuff for Zoey coming up.
Where'd you go?
What'd you do?
What happened?
Zoey's living with Scarlett right now?
No, I have my own place.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then. But Scarlett don't know. Okay. I'm just joking. Oh, my God.
You're terrible.
Looks could kill. I just died.
I feel like it's going to be good. I'm excited to see where your storyline goes.
I'm excited for you guys to see
how many episodes ahead
goes.
Are you all right now? How many have you shot?
I've shot 1 through 7. They're finishing 8.
Okay.
And I go back for 9 and 10.
Oh, nice. That's
and I'm,
good.
Yeah, I'm episode to episode. I'm kind of at their mercy, which is fine with me.
Yeah, that's a good chunk, though. That's like half of the season.
Yeah,
right
that's awesome.
I love it. That's
it's
great.
A good storyline.
We're excited.
We're like really into this storyline.
Yeah?
Yeah, like we're really excited about it.
It's mixed it up. It's good. Not just like the love triangle anymore.
It's a square. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We've added an edge.
Well, we pretty much wrapped up. Do you have any other points on the episode?
Oh, we didn't talk about Peggy.
Oh, Teddy and Peggy.
We'll talk about her bunny boiler. Bunny boiler.
Very she's first thing, so... Teddy's an idiot. She want to see the doctor's things, and he says no.
Yeah. Like, I don't care about this kid.
Like, you
fake kid.
Yeah, but like, you're in the a political figure. You know she's crazy. She's already tried to kill herself. Don't you think one of the first things you'd be is like, no, I really want to see
but
all
it would be
these.
Fake. Things. It would be fake, and it would have worked.
I know, but
that's true.
I don't think it would have been fake. I think she knew that he wouldn't ask her for it.
But would she have taken the chance?
No, she definitely had backup plans. Her backup plan now is let's get in bed and make this real baby. And
but wouldn't he seriously? He would know though, because she's wearing a fake belly, which you can obviously see. So if he takes off her clothes, she's gonna be a pillow underneath that.
She's
shirt.
Not that pregnant. Like she could get pregnant right now if they get together, and it'll be like.
But in the scene, you could see
belly,
that she had a bump.
I thought she had a belly.
Yeah,
a little bit.
I didn't
bit.
See that either. I missed that
How
one.
How many months? Oh, it's God. Just been a week.
Hopefully that wasn't just her.
Yeah.
Yikes.
You know.
I'm pretty sure there was a belly. It was like a tight-fitted shirt, and then she kept putting her hands on it, too.
Yeah, no, she's a tiny thing.
It's a little bump, but not a big
like,
bump.
Yeah, like a little one, like a month, I would think.
Like a food baby
bump. Yeah, but
bump.
She really don't. I don't know. I think she's got her ways.
She's crazy.
She's like, but we can get back together. It can work.
Crazy. And goes in for the kiss. Yeah.
And he kissed her back.
He did.
Okay, because he's so, like, strangling. He's so needy right now.
Midlife crisis.
I did come out of this episode liking Teddy because I felt like he put a fire under Deacon's butt, which I appreciate.
Mm-hmm.
I agree.
He was
he's
mean
good
about
for
it, though.
Yeah, he's just a mean guy.
But sometimes you need, like, I think Deacon needed that. He needed some, like, tough talking to by somebody.
But it wasn't like Teddy cared about him. He cares about Maddie. He's not telling Deacon,
I know.
Let me help you.
But, and, like, he was showing Deacon, like, this is what a father needs to do. I am fighting for my daughter right now, and she needs you to be in her life in a positive manner. She is watching you.
But that little, that thing, the remark he said at the end, that was so unnecessary.
What
about less
it?
Of a man
yes.
or something.
Yeah, you're
come
right.
Come on, like...
Well, he's super jealous of Deacon. He always has been. Mm-hmm. And who wouldn't be? Hello.
Right, hello.
Yeah, hello.
And he's never really had a chance, like, one-on-one to, like, really stick it to him.
Right, so. And I think that was his chance.
I guess I'm still not really sold on the whole decision-making process behind this either. Like, I get what they're saying, and I get why Deacon's thanking him, but I still think, no, like, it's so wrong that you lied to him for so many years about it being his son, and the fact that you and Rayna came up with this plan together to let's lie to all these people for all these years is not a good plan.
It's not, but Deacon keeps saying, I wish she would have never found out. Like, he wishes it could go back the other way. I think it's because he's scared.
He really doesn't. Yeah, he's just saying that because he's, afraid that he would have ruined something, but I really think when he gets through all the therapy, he's going to have anger issues with the fact that they lied to him for so many years.
Well, he's going to have all those different levels of grief, whatever, that you have to go through. Yeah, he's dealing with that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Deacon. Mm-hmm.
And did he ask for weed to deal with the hand thing now? Is that what he said the doctor did? Am I making something up? When he's,
I think
he made that up.
Okay.
I couldn't hear it because he didn't want the pill, but then he said something like, I'll take the herb. Maybe it was just herbal. Something.
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe I'm
how
just,
gross did that
oh my
little thing look?
Just,
yeah.
The little that's staples are
gotta be painful.
Nice makeup job on that.
Well, Deacon's lost his guitar skills. Raina's lost her voice. What are they going to do?
Oh, boy.
How are they going to come back from this people?
The drama.
Zoey's gonna start singing.
Yeah.
Come on in.
Well,
And I'm going to start drinking.
All right. There you go.
Start singing and drinking and makeup for Deacon and Rayna.
I love it.
Yes. Let's do get back to you.
Oh, no,
so let's talk about how excited were you when you got the call that you were going to be on the show?
Oh, here, can I, let me just tell you the story of how.
Please.
I want to hear about the audition, too.
Okay, mm-hmm. So I have a friend who I haven't talked to in a while named Dustin from Indiana who sends me a Facebook message Tuesday night. It was like 8:30. Hey, just want to let you know my girlfriend's best friend plays Scarlett on Nashville. They're looking for a black actress who sings. So I just thought I'd pass it along to you. Oh. So I copy and paste that and send it to my agent Tuesday night. Wednesday morning, he emails me, like, your wish is my command. You have an audition tomorrow, Thursday. So Thursday, I go in and I audition. Apparently, this is
in
L.A.
Okay.
They've searched far and wide for this character. Mm-hmm. So they're like, I don't know what round of auditions it was. And I go in and I read for Jeannie, and she's like, can you stay? I'm going to bring a producer in. Like, yeah. Went back to the waiting room, and then I watched other girls leave, and I'm freaking out, and I go in and I sing for Callie, and they were so cool. And
what'd you sing?
I sang, what did I sing? Mahalia Jackson. Why can't I remember it? Because I'm thinking of a song I sing on the show. Mm-hmm. Anyway, ooh. I...
Spoiler.
Right? So that was Thursday. Friday, I get the call. You booked it. And I couldn't.
How did you feel? Awesome.
I was stunned and terrified. I was in Nashville the next day.
Wow.
And so I get to Nashville, and I'm an emotional wreck. I get on the plane. I see Eric Close, who plays Teddy. Uh-huh. I was like, I don't want to interrupt you, but I just got a part on your show. And all of first class goes, Zoey! Because it was all the writers.
Oh, my God.
And so it was just like, I get to the hotel, and the guy at the front desk is like, so your checkout date is in a month? And I was just like, what? I couldn't figure out what was going on with my life.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
I love it.
It was amazing.
Wow. That's right place, right time kind of thing in terms
like
of like hearing
part.
It.
Yeah.
It was meant to for be. You. I love that.
And great of the friend to send you that Facebook.
Yeah.
Like,
wow.
I owe him lunch. I haven't had a moment to, because I want to take him and his girlfriend and go out with my boyfriend.
Dustin's
to
his name?
Yeah.
You tell him.
Dustin lunch.
Thank you, Dustin.
Good job, Dustin.
Basically, awesome. Dustin cast. Like,
basically.
So what do you feel like when you go onto a set of a new show and you don't really know anyone? Like, what's going through your mind?
I did. You know, I moved to New York, and I was, like, starving and going to acting class and waitressing. And then I started going to these casting director workshops. No one was paying any attention to me. I didn't get any work in New York. Moved to L.A. with my boyfriend, and I got, like, commercial rep. So literally October 16th, a year ago, I booked my first SAG job, which is Jack in the Box.
Oh, was awesome. It the Nuggets?
Yes.
I watched your commercial.
Thank you.
She steals all the nuggets, and she's got like the sauce on there.
It was an improv spot. I got Taft Hartley'd in for that because I was a non-union actor. Awesome casting director for that. And then I booked two more jobs because of that commercial. One was another improv spot with Jason Alexander. Then the next was Charlie Sheen, who reached out to me, gave me a one-liner on anger management because of the Jack in the Box commercial.
Wow. Nice.
One word, but it was really generous.
Yeah.
He didn't hit on me. He was sober and very respectful and nice guy.
That's awesome.
Let's put that out there.
Wow.
Yeah. And that was the only, I can't hear you. That was the only, that's the only TV set I've been on. Other than Nashville.
Wow.
So
that's huge.
Wow. Yeah.
Well, this is going to be huge, I feel like. Yeah. I mean, that's awesome.
I was going to ask you about the singing, because when I was doing the research, I saw that you have some things on YouTube that you've posted of yourself, like singing.
So
is it Tony Braxton?
Yeah. I should probably take that.
No, it was good. Yeah. So
my hair was black.
I wonder. Yeah, you looked adorable. I was like, oh, I wonder if she is going to be singing, but now you've told us you will.
I'll be singing very soon.
Yay!
I sing next week.
Oh, yay!
I don't know if I'm allowed to tell you that.
Hey.
Too late.
You heard it here first.
Exclusive. I love it.
We won't tell anyone.
AFTERBUZZ TV exclusive.
Yes.
I know.
Like Steven's sleeping back there.
come on.
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
There we go.
Love it.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Yay. That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's so you cool. sing, you dance?
Not really.
No. But you were a gymnast. Did I read
I
that?
Was. Yeah. I quit when I was 16 and grew 3 inches.
Oh, well, wow. Yeah. Wouldn't have worked then.
No.
You got to be short to be a gymnast these days.
Yeah, I was already tallish, and then I quit, and it was like...
Yeah. And did you just know acting was what you wanted to do?
I always wanted to be a singer, and that's what I moved to New York to do originally, was to sing. And I was, you know, small-town girl, you know, and I moved to New York, like, I'm going to make it. And I moved to New York, and I was, like, working retail and hostessing and cater waiting and waitressing, and I was just like, I'm not going to make it. And then I had some really weird, bad experiences in the music industry with men. It's hard when you're a young girl without, like, the support of representation or manager or something. And I was like, you know what, I'm going to take a break. I'm going to audition for this acting coach. Amazing. His name's Anthony Abeson in New York. Love that man. It's where I met my boyfriend. We were scene partners in that class.
I love it. That's a good story.
I know. And then I just became obsessed, and I was just like,
this is it.
These nerdy notes. I made an outline of my notes.
Oh, I love it.
But and it's more terrifying for me than singing, acting. Because I started kind of late, and I have so much to learn. I'm in, like, I'm learning so much on the set. It's like being thrown into the deep end. But the great thing is that everyone's so supportive. They really are, of me just, like the the DP is always like, Chaley, you're light. You're blocking your light. And he says it with a smile, but he has to tell me every day, like, okay. You're blocking your light.
You say it's terrifying, and you were, you know, had those feelings when you were first going into Nashville. How do you get through those things? Like, on that first day when you said you had a 15-hour day on your very first day. Like,
I mean,
how was that process?
It wasn't an issue because I was so, that terror kind of, I get to use that, that being unsure. Whereas, like, when I sing, I can tell I'm on. You know, I know it's if it's good or not, if I'm connected or not. So with acting, I have a lot of, like, learning about my instrument to do, and it's exciting. So I was just so excited that first day that, I mean, Callie was watching the monitors, and she was like, your excitement is palpable because my character is so excited to be the Bluebird. Huh. And I was like, that's because I'm really freaking excited.
That's to awesome.
Be here.
Yeah. So on set, is there, like, a set clown? Like, who, like, is goofy on set?
Well,
what are, like, the on-set secrets that we don't know?
Chris Carmack is hilarious. I don't know if I just think he's hilarious, but he just says the goofiest stuff. Like, I can picture him as an old man just saying these weird things that... Or just, what is your brain? That's what I ask. What is your brain? Oliver Hudson's also really funny. I don't work with him that often. But, mostly Chris. Derek, who plays Brent, seems to capture these moments when we're eating, where I'm laughing. And Chris is kind of just smiling, kind of proud of himself for making me laugh.
That's funny.
He's funny.
So is it fun to get your hair and makeup done every time?
You know what? It is. I was really excited about the first time.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I go in and I've got this crazy hair that they end up kind of wrapping each curl around a curling iron.
Oh, man. Wow.
Kind of just smooth out the hair. So that gets tedious. But the hair and makeup trailer is always a fun place to be. It's like the salon. You know,
like full of gossip.
They know everything. Because you just go sit in that chair and you're just like, this is what's going on, blah, blah, blah. And
it's
you
like
just
therapy.
Unload.
Yeah. Nice. That's always fun.
Yeah.
I take it.
Are there any, like, cliques on set?
Not really. I don't think. I mean, there's the group of us who hang out a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just mostly the people who are... There's Aubrey and Derek and I stay in the same hotel. So I call us the B Squad because we're all new this season. And if we go out, no one knows who we are, but they're asking the other guys for their pictures, and we're just like, we're on the show, too.
By the way.
No one knows.
Hello.
So I've got my B-squad.
They'll wake up soon.
They'll know. Now they'll know, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, but those two, Aubrey and Derek, B-squad, they're in L.A. right now.
And that's Layla.
Layla and Britt. And,
yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Might have to get the rest of the B squad.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Should.
Get a little party in here.
B squad party. So do you guys go out often in Nashville?
We do, actually. I was talking to EJ about this, like, in
go
LA.
Go-to places? Any go-to places in Nashville?
I really like this bar called Losers.
I love Losers.
I don't know why I love it so much.
Me too. It's very fun.
It is fun.
What's Losers like?
Losers has, like, is Whiskey Jam at Losers? Mm-hmm. Whiskey Jam is on Sunday or Monday, and it's live bands.
But they have, like, a Losers and a Winners, but everyone goes to
bar,
the Losers.
Winners bar.
It's funny.
I don't know. I just like it.
Yeah. It's just fun. It's loud. Relaxed. You never know who you're going to see. Like, last time I was there, Zach Brown was just playing. Like,
really?
Not because his band was there. He was just like, let me get up and sing a song. Oh, so that's the cool thing.
Yeah. And then there's, like, I don't have a kitchen, so we go out to eat all the time.
Yeah. Lots all of good the stuff there.
Southern food. What's the best barbecue in Nashville?
I don't know if they're known for barbecue, really. I think that's Memphis. Yeah. They do hot chicken in Nashville.
Hot chicken?
Mm. Hot chicken.
So there's Prince's hot chicken. I've never had Prince's. I forget what we had on set one day, which is really good. But there's hot chicken. That's their thing.
What's hot chicken?
It's like basically like breaded, fried, spicy chicken.
Ooh.
But there's no sauce. You know what I mean? It's not hot wings.
I might have to make myself a trip to Nashville.
I know.
Nashville's a cool city. It's really fun.
How different is it from LA to you? Like, what are the differences?
It's very different in that, I mean, it just feels kind of like it's all a little more compact.
Mm-hmm.
And there's more warmth from people. And there's just a whole bunch of music.
Yeah.
Just everywhere. I feel like in New York as well, where L.A. it's all spread out and chill, I feel more inspired in Nashville than I do in L.A., like to be creative.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's interesting.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Does it have more energy, too, then, since it is more compact?
Yeah, it really does. I mean, there's, like, and I'm close to Vanderbilt University, and so there's, like, all the college students, and then there's just food and, you know, music. It's
definitely going to be an experience because it's like L.A., going to Nashville for a little bit, then you'll be back, like, you know. And that's the cool thing about being an actor, I think. I would think. Not that I am one, but, like, what I'm saying is it'd be cool to travel different places and see what it's like.
It's hard when I have my little...
Your man.
Your boo. Your boo. So I know a lot of you guys are musicians and singers, obviously, on the show. Do you guys kind of have jam sessions together ever?
What I've been in that setting maybe once. They'll bring their guitars to set and just kind of, I don't play anything. But not a lot for me.
Mm-hmm.
One night we were all hanging out with guitars, taking turns singing. I wasn't playing again, but I did sing.
Oh, that's fun.
And that is fun.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is.
Are you trying to learn from them how to play guitar at all?
No. I want to take drum lessons.
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Nice.
That's a fun one.
It's like Josie and the Pussycats. Yeah. I always wanted to learn how to play drums because I saw that movie, and my mom was like, absolutely not.
That's great.
So did I read that you auditioned for Idol?
I did.
What was that like?
Twice, actually.
Nice.
Well, it was very interesting. It's just a weird situation. I feel like... I mean, I don't want to say anything bad. It's just like, if you don't have
exactly
a wonderful tale to tell, you come with less. You know what I mean? So I forget what city I was in. I made it to the second round. It's like, awesome. And I'm watching these people, like, just it's a little sad watching these really strange people who can't sing and they don't know it. And they're being kind of... You know, they're being made fun of.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to watch when you're actually... I mean, it's my favorite part of the show, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
It's harder to watch when you're there and you're watching them kind of...
So those people really don't know that they can't sing.
I don't believe that they know that they can't sing.
I can't even... I can't watch those rounds. I feel too sorry for them.
I watch them. I think they're hilarious.
I'm like, oh.
Before you booked the these gigs in L.A., did you ever think about maybe auditioning for The Voice or X Factor?
You know, I was hesitant to do American Idol.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that after the second time, I was like, you know what? I don't want to do reality TV.
Yeah.
Although a lot of the people who are, I think like The Voice, American Idol, that stuff is different because they're not showing all this behind the scenes drama and like creating the the bitchy girl and the drama queen. So that's, those people tend to go on and really do well. But I kind of...
I mean, you're on Nashville. Hello.
Yeah, you're doing okay.
You're singing. Like, your decisions panned out. Yeah,
it worked out perfectly.
So, what would be what would be your dream role if you could get what one you really wanted?
Well, I think that I am best with comedy. I definitely want, like, I would love to do a Judd Apatow film. Mm-hmm. But then on the other hand, I want to be one of those like gun wielding. Oh, patent leather suit wearing sci-fi badass, you know,
Battlestar Galactica,
stuff like that. Star Wars,
nice.
I know they're holding auditions for those new Star Wars films. Yeah. Did you audition for those?
I did. You go, girl. Say that?
Sure.
I don't know.
I did.
You go, girl. You're working.
Yeah.
Awesome. I had that actually in News and Gossip because I believe one of your other co-stars wants to be in a Star Wars.
Yeah.
Sam.
Like, just think, like, three actors from Nashville, like, get cast in Star Wars film. That would be so great.
What's happening here? Yeah. Southern accents. Yeah.
All right.
Well, I think we're just about out of time for this evening, so let's go ahead and get into some of our
predictions.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Predictions.
AfterBuzz TV.
Nope. Never mind.
Oh, news and gossip. We'll do news and gossip. Okay.
Predict one.
AfterBuzz TV news.
Sorry about that, Steven. All right. Oh, okay, I got it tonight. Okay, well, we'll be quick on the news and gossip. What I just mentioned is that Sam Palladio also, he has a great article, if you guys want to check it out, in Interview Magazine. He's got some great photos. And he just kind of talks about his like roles that he would like to have, and he would like to be in a Star Wars film, and he also is going to be actually
those kind eyes.
He is also in the new movie Runner Runner that is out with
JT and Ben Affleck.
Yeah, and I didn't know that, so learn something good.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah, so that's something fun to check out.
Reason to see the movie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then, the other thing that I had sent, you should check out NashvilleLifestyle.com named Chip Esten one of the top 25 most beautiful people. Ooh,
one
in
of
Nashville.
Them.
Yeah, right. So
the
yeah.
Come on.
Yeah. The man.
Yeah,
of
the
century.
Man. So he's got another great photo in there, too. So that's something fun you guys can check out.
Awesome.
So that is
it. Oh, wait. Oh. I don't know if you guys heard, but I just want to plug this band really quick. Oh, yeah. Jared and the Mill. They had a song featured in today's episode called Returning Half. They're on tour right now with their debut album, Western Expansion, and they're playing in LA this Friday, October 11th at 10 p.m. If you guys want to check them out, they're going to be at the Hotel Cafe in LA. We're all going to go, a couple of us are actually going to go down and do a quick interview with them, and they're going to call in next week. So tune in for that. Jared and the Mill. They kind of have like a What were we saying? Like Mumford and Sons kind of sound to
Zach
them?
Zach Brown Bandish a little.
Yeah, they're great.
Folky,
I'm excited.
Good stuff. Me too.
So tune in next week.
All right.
All right, now that we can move on into predictions.
And now this is where it's going to get
out. After Buzz TV.
Oh, there's lightning effects.
Mm-hmm. So creepy.
Right?
Yeah, who wants to start?
I don't know.
I'm going to make people angry, so I'm not going to start.
Well, my prediction was that Zoey here was going to try to put the moves on Gunner, and they were going to hook up.
Oh!
I don't know. Wait.
Something.
Anything.
I think, I don't think it's just going to be, I think that's going to be a mutual put the moves on each other moment. I think that's going to be a moment.
Can you tell us there's a guy in your future? Are you allowed to say that?
I don't know what I'm allowed to say.
We can't get her in trouble.
We can't get her in trouble. So
I should ask if I'm allowed to say that.
Yeah.
What if there's a chick in my future?
Oh, Santana style from Glee. Yeah. You know?
Well, we don't know what Zoe's going to bring to the table.
She's having fun, remember?
Yeah.
I also think one other prediction is I do think Deacon is going to be the one to go bring Maddie back when she runs away.
Oh.
So that I'll start their bonding.
That's a good one. I like that.
That's good.
That's all I got this week.
My prediction kind of comes over from last week, where I think that, obviously, Rayna mentioned she's going to try to get out of her contract, and that's when I think Juliette's going to come with her. and they're all gonna leave Edge Hill. Leave him in the dust, people, that Jeff. And my other one was that I think Peggy is gonna just try to hook up with Teddy and get really pregnant, like real life pregnant. We'll see.
Good ones. I have no predictions.
Oh, gosh. I think that Jeff and Edge Hill are gonna pay off what's his name? That's working with Rayna right now?
Liam.
Liam, I think they're gonna pay off Liam to get some background information from about Rayna, and when they find out she can't sing anymore, they're gonna offer him a big lots of money to come over and work for them, and then he's gonna end up leaving Rayna. And she's gonna crawl back to Deacon.
Maybe
she's gonna be sad. She's gonna be sad.
That might
that's
be
a good one.
That might be good.
That
she
is
won't
a good
get
one.
What she wants.
Oh no. Yeah. I don't know, we had a little reaction over here. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I kind of like that one.
Lots of predictions. So I don't know. We'll
all
see.
Right. Where can we find everybody? I guess that's where we are.
All right. I'm at JJ Jurgens on Twitter and jjjurgens.com.
You can find me on Twitter at KeetinM33 and on Instagram at Keetin33.
I'm on Twitter at Whitney Lane Fern, and my website's whitney-lane.firm. .com.
Oh.
Not my last name.
I'm on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at Violet Kanian.
And
I am Chaley Rose on Twitter and Instagram.
Yay! Thank you.
Thank you so much, Chaley.
Forward to watching you the rest of the season. So everybody tune in.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And I hope you get in Once Upon a Time.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.